Listen, God can do it again. I've been praying all day today, Lord, just do it again. And begin to think about, it seemed like the Lord gave us a message on that, I know, several months ago about, I believe the work got out what Jesus was doing. Everywhere he went, he was touching people. Everywhere he went, the blind was seeing, the lame was walking, and folks were being helped. And I could just hear people saying, "Did you hear about it yesterday? What happened? He done it again." Why now that they said that Lazarus was called from the dead, been dead 4 days, and why the Lord's done it again? What'd you hear about the blind Bartimaeus? Why he'd been blind from his birth, but the Bible says that Jesus passed by and Jesus touched his eyes, and hey, he done it again. Amen. Yeah. Yeah, I believe tonight, before we leave here, I believe we can say he done it again. But we've got to let him tonight. Amen. So tonight, if we get in one accord, in one place like we did last night, one accord means in being in agreement. Amen. Two or more agree is touching anything they shall ask, it shall be done to them of my Father which is in heaven. Matthew 18:19. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there I'll be in the midst. That's being in agreement. Amen. That's waiting. When they were there again, when they were there in the upper room, they were there for one purpose and one purpose only. When Jesus left, he said, "Tarry ye here at Jerusalem, for endued ye shall be endued with power from on high." And so they were there waiting on the promise. They were there focused on God. I don't believe they were there thinking, "Well, I hope he hurries. I've got to be home by 2:00, or I've got to be doing this, or got to be doing that." They weren't worried about what they had to go to. They were concerned about being there and receiving the promise. Now, I believe when we come into the house of God, we need to be in one accord, just waiting on God, waiting on God to move and lift his name up and praise him and worship him, for he alone is worthy, ain't he? Amen. All right, good to be here tonight. We got much to be in prayer about. Brother Jim Shoup, let's remember him and his family. He wasn't able to be with us tonight. His daughter-in-law, they put her in the hospital this evening. She's 31 weeks pregnant, and her blood pressure has been spiking. It spiked again today. It was very, very high, and because of her safety and the safety of the baby, they have put her in the hospital, and they're going to induce labor. As I understand, they're inducing her this evening as we speak. And so when the baby is born, they're going to put it in the NICU, and it'll be there for several weeks. She's 31 weeks, so they're expecting it to be in the NICU at least 6 weeks till, to 37 weeks is considered full term, I think. So let's just pray for mother and baby that God would just overshadow them with his healing hand. And let's remember Jim in prayer. His heart is with us, and he wanted to be with us. But he said, I just feel like we need to be there. And I said, "Brother, you be with your family. That's where you need to be." And so I do pray for him and his family tonight. I'll be with pray for all of our sick and in our church. Melissa Edwards had her surgery today, and they was able to successfully do the surgery. She's doing okay. They've admitted her there, and she'll be at least in the hospital overnight, maybe longer, but hopefully just overnight. So let's keep her in prayer, and let's remember Allison Tittle. She's had a bad day today. She's about 15 years old, and she's had heart problems and from COVID, and also she's having seizures on top of that. And she's had a bad day, her mother said. So let's remember them in prayer. And we've got a lot of others in our church that are sick, and pray for one for another. Good to see Mike Janice with us tonight. He's been a sick man, and good to see him, and thank the Lord for him being with us tonight. Amen. All right. Anybody have a spoken up request? Right, unspoken request, lift the hand. Let's all come, Ken and Will, come around the altar, remember the man of God tonight as he stands. Remember Brother Allen as he sings for us. We pray for him. And let's just have church tonight. Amen. Come right on. That's Mike to lead some prayer.
Our dear Lord, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for this day. Thank you, God, for our new grace. God, we just bring God all of this temple. God, I thank you, Lord, for having me. Lord, we present, Lord, we have you. You're good, God, for this people. And all things possible. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for your mission.
Come on, choir, let's sing a few there. Come on, choir. Come join us in the choir. If you sing in the choir at your church, please come and help us sing, all right? We're going to sing in that heavenly choir together, and we might as well just practice in this choir, amen? You sing in the choir at your church, come sing with us.
Six.
you and all that you know. That deep settled peace. Bless his name.
1:16.
Trusting fully, trusting in the Savior's love.
am worthless, a hopeless sinner, that's true. But that is just part of the story. I haven't told everything. I was lost, reborn, and raised, a child of the in
Amen. Love that song. Amen. I love that part. I'm part of the bloodline. Amen. Amen. We've been born into the family of God. Amen. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, joint heirs of Christ Jesus. We've been grafted in, been adopted into the family of God. Amen. The adoptee, when you read about adoption, the adoptee, they've got all rights as if they were born into the family. Amen. I'm glad that, friend, when we're born into the family of God, we're part of the bloodline. Amen. Amen. It's good to be saved, ain't it? Sure is. Sure is. Good to have Alan Foster with us tonight. You come right on, brother.
Sing that verse one more time. great judgment morning, just to touch all the nail prints in his feet and his hands, just to touch all the nail prints in his feet and his hands.
Thank the Lord for the plan of salvation, don't you? It gives us all the opportunity to go to heaven if we choose to. I teach it at church a whole lot. Life's about choices, isn't it? We've all got the choice to go if we choose to. I thank the Lord for the plan of salvation. Brother Roger asked me if I'd come out and sing tonight. And Sherry, she was here the other night. And I knew Sherry when she was a child. Her grandfather was Robert Story, and Robert sang with my dad, Simon, and me when I was a kid, so I've known her. I just don't see her very often, so we just fall in and sing like we did yesterday. So I appreciate her coming tonight, and I had that song on my mind. I used to sing that with my dad and my Uncle Arnie all the time. And my dad will be dead 8 years on the 19th of this month, and I think that's the first time I've sung that song since he died. But I just had it on my heart this week, and I sent it to Sherry, and I said, see if you can play this. The plan of salvation, how I love that song. But I love the Lord most of all, and as I look around this church and grow up in this community, I see a lot of faces that's no longer here, but it's like that in a lot of our churches. People are going on to be with the Lord, but we'll be with them again. Think about Brother Terry Williams sitting back there. I think about his dad, Arville, a lot. Arville would come to our church, and we'd gather around the piano. My dad would play the piano, and Arville would come, and my Uncle Arnie would sing the tenor, and I'd just play the bass. But I knew at some point in the song, Brother Arville would quit singing on I Want to Live There, Don't You? And he would begin to shout, and I would jump in, and I would sing his part. While he shouted how he loved the Lord. And when you're gathered around all of that, you don't think a whole lot about it until it's gone.
That's the truth.
I said all that to say this. If you still have your family, young people, your parents, your grandparents, be sure and tell them you love them. Every day that you can, all these people that you're around, that's in your circle, your church family, you tell these people you love them. There'll be a day you can't sit on this side of life anymore with them. We'll meet them again someday. So it's good to be here. I thank the Lord for the plan of salvation. I'll sing a couple of more songs. I'm going to try the land of the living. What key we do that in earlier? G.
Okay.
There's a river somewhere that's called Jordan, and they say that it's deep and wide, and they say that the king and the beggar on that shore will stand side by side. Of the Jordan, why should I be afraid? There'll be someone there who loves me to guide me across the river to endless joys above. It's dark and so stormy, it will pass like a dream in the night, and my soul will awaken the morning in regions of endless delight at the cross of the Jordan. Why should I be afraid? There'll be someone there who loves me to guide me across the river to endless joys above. Like a dream in the night, then my soul will awaken the morning in regions of endless delight at the crossing,
at the crossing
of the Jordan. Why should I be afraid? There'll be someone there who loves me to guide me across the river to endless joys above, to endless joys.
She said, no, I'm good.
I'm out.
She's wore out. So we're both battling allergies and sinuses and all that good stuff. So I'll try one more and then we'll turn it over to the preacher. Let's do it. And now I'll have everything.
What can you do?
Can you do A flat?
I'd rather do G.
Okay.
But I can. I messed it up.
But doubt and confusion.
life eternal. And
now I have everything.
This next verse is what a lot of people are doing today. Listen to it now. I was making big plans for the future, but I was living my lifetime in vain, till I made him life's only true meaning. And now I have everything. I have
everything, everything I need to make me happy. Jesus to show me the way.
He has saved me and gave me life eternal. And
now I have everything.
And
now I
have.
They said they didn't feel good, but they didn't sing like it, did they? Amen. Lord give them strength, did he? Lord help them. Amen. I like that last song they sung. And you know, there's a lot of people, I think, in this revival that God has given them a zeal that they've got life worth more living now, because their relationship with God is where it needs to be now. Amen. I believe if people, when you get revived, and people, we've had a lot of, I believe we've had more rededications in this revival than what we realize. I know we've had a couple, but it's untelling. But I believe that's what revival's about, to getting things back in perspective. And when you get God where he needs to be in your life, and that's center, that's front and center. Amen. And when everything else evolves around him and his will, its life is worth living. Amen. There's hope. There's peace. There's joy. Amen. You're still going to have troubles and problems. But boy, when you've got God to look to, and your relationship with God is in check, and you're in fellowship with God, oh, mercy, it makes life a whole lot easier, worth living. Amen. Amen. Good to be here tonight, and appreciate you tonight. And I don't know if I've already, but appreciate everybody being with us from all over. I see Pathways let their Wednesday night service out and come with us to be with us. We appreciate you, Brother Shane, and your church coming and being with us, and other churches that's let out fellowship. And good to have you. Some from Higgins, good to see them. And other churches around, we appreciate you being with us, and thank you for being here. Amen. Pray for the man of God as he comes tonight. Come on, Daddy.
Sitting there thinking, how long can you go on one meal? Now, I ate a good supper a little while ago, but I'm going to tell you something. By in the morning, I'm going to be starved to death. I said all that to say this. Now, listen. If you didn't get your tank full last night, honey, it wasn't God's fault. It is yours. Amen. I went home. I was thinking, I was telling my two sisters last night, and we went down there, and they had pulled it up on my sister's phone watching it. And I watched it again till about 2 o'clock this morning. Amen. But what a joy that it is that the Word is made possible, that like my two sisters, they're taking care of Mom 24/7. They can take and enjoy the good things of God. And so as we take and look today, we got filled up last night, but we're seemingly extremely quiet tonight. Amen. I'm going to tell you something. That's been put on record. This is a brand new service. Would have been more. Hey, I couldn't wait to get here. You know why? Hey, I loved what happened last night. I got my part last night. Did you? Did you move when God took and spoke to your heart, or done what God told you to do? If you did, you went home rejoicing. Amen. And so tonight, this is a brand new service. We need to take and if we did not, the Word teach us that He'd give us desires of our heart. You desire to take and have another round of that we had last night, you can have it. Amen. Obedience is all it takes, is just obedience. To do what God tells you to do. I can't do what God tells you to do, but I can do what God tells me to do. Amen. And if everybody would do that, I'll guarantee you, honey, that the preacher wouldn't get to preach a lot of times as he didn't last night. Amen. We do appreciate Sherry and Alan singing tonight for us. We appreciate them so much. Appreciate their churches. As like Kevin's already said, all the churches, especially I thank my church, of coming and being with us tonight. We're honored and honored to be with you tonight. I'm not a long-winded preacher. I just give what the Lord gives me, and I go to the house. Amen? But I'm going to give you what the Lord's given me. If you got your Bibles, and turn with us. And before I read tonight, I want to ask you something. Do you need help tonight? Do you need help? I'm going to leave you at that thought. Now we're going to take it and get into the Scripture. Do you need help tonight? Matthew chapter 9 and verse 9. And as Jesus passed forth from thence, He saw a man named Matthew sitting at the reception of custom, and He said unto him, "Follow me." And he arose and followed him. And it came to pass, as Jesus sat at meat in the house, behold, many publicans and sinners came and sat down with him and his disciples. And when the Pharisees saw it, they said unto his disciples, "Why eatest your master with the publicans and sinners?" Now listen, when Jesus heard that, He said unto them, "They that be whole need not a physician, but they that are sick. But go ye and learn what that meaneth. I will have mercy and not sacrifice. For I am not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance." Heavenly Father, we thank You for the reading of Your Word. Lord, we come tonight knowing and realizing, God, without Your touch, without You giving that is needed tonight, Lord, I can do nothing. Lord, You know what every one of our hearts need tonight. God, I pray that You just take and get me out of the way. And God, I pray that You just speak through us what is needed for the air. I pray, Lord, that You would speak to hearts tonight. Lord, that when it has needs tonight, God, may they call upon You for that is needed. And Lord, I know that You're sufficient for that every need, no matter what it may be, no matter how small or large that it may be. God, you're sufficient for that need. Lord, we love you, thank you, and praise you now for all that you've gave us and done for us, most of all for saving us. God bless now. I pray that some soul will come to know you as Lord and Savior of their life this night. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. I want us to take and look at this tonight. I thought about Brother Gary back there. Great man of God. I appreciate him, and a great doctor. And I was thinking as I was studying today that I had took and took a Q-tip and got a train to clean my ear out and pull the end of the Q-tip off. And I knowed, it was absolutely driving me crazy. I couldn't stand it. So we took and got a hold of Brother Gary back there, and he knowed exactly what to do. Now, I didn't need Brother Gary's, maybe what he thought. I needed help. He already knowed what I needed. And so by doing that, I took and went to his office. And I said I was trying to clean my ear out, and I got a Q-tip in my ear, and it's driving me crazy. Do you know he knowed exactly how to take care of that? And so when I went in there, I was really in trouble. But when I came out of there, I was tickled to death. That wasn't bothering me no more. Amen? And so as we look tonight, as here that Jesus was eating meat in his house, and here come the the Pharisees, and they... of the publicans and sinners, but the Pharisees seen them do that. Now listen, I'll say something tonight. Don't think yourself more highly than you ought to think. Because I'm going to tell you something. Honey, I'm glad that the ground is level at the foot of the cross. It doesn't matter how important you may be. It don't matter how much you may have in this walk of life. But I want to tell you something. Jesus still loves old sinners. Amen. And so as we look and see how that here are these publicans and sinners come in. But here comes the Pharisees now wanting to know why. That to ask the disciples that why is their master eating? Yeah, and I didn't turn my mic on. Thank you. That Esther was eating with sinners and publicans. And so Jesus shared this. Yes. By the way, he hears everything. Yes, he does. Amen. He knows everything. Yes. Amen. And so here are these ones that the publicans and sinners, here they needed to hear what the Lord had to say. Yes. Amen. They come to one that they knowed that could help them. Amen. It's like I went back to our dear brother over there for help, and I got it. Amen. I know that he could take care of what I needed. And so as we come tonight and as we look and see, the Pharisees was looking down on Jesus because who he was eating with. Listen, I want you to listen again what verse 12 said. But when Jesus heard that, he said unto them, they that be whole need not a physician, but they that are sick. Yeah. You know, I got to think, listen, we take and look at people that says, you know, and say, well, they're drug addicts. They may be drunks or prostitutes, all these other different things. Yeah. But listen at me. I got to think about myself. I was took to church all of my life. And I wasn't no discussion when it come church time, we went to church. Amen. My mom and daddy didn't ask who is going to church. They say, we're going to church. We never did get to ask our mom and dad what to do. They told us what to do. Amen? But listen, I didn't know what I still don't know what drugs is. I don't know what alcohol is. I always was tuck to church. But guess what? I was a sinner. Back in 1965, Jesus came to my house. No man of God got up. I couldn't told you what he preached till this day. But I'll tell you something. God spoke to my heart at age 13. Amen? And I'll say something. I needed something that my little old grandma, she could shout all over the house, a holy, just like that dear sister last night. I want to say, bless your heart, that blessed me. Hey, Brother Jim said that's a real thing right there. Well, glory to God. When God's in something, it's a real thing. Amen. You can tell. I don't have to ask nobody. You know why? He lives in me. Amen. I know the power of God. Glory to God. That blessed my heart. But my little grandma used to do that. She'd get up and shout the praises of God. But I'll tell you something. I still lost. Because grandma had power with God didn't mean I had it. Amen. I needed it. I didn't have it. But guess what I found out, Brother Allen? I could have exactly what she had. Glory to God. You know how you do that? Hey, you got to get to the great physician. Amen. He had exactly what these publicans and sinners here. He had exactly what they stood in need of. And so they went to the great physician. Amen. Hey. In anybody, you can take the most important people in the world and specialists, maybe, I mean, the best of the best, but you know they still, there's limits on what they can do. Amen. Amen. Brother back there, I'd say that he knows exactly what he can do. Huh? That gets better. I know exactly what he can do. Amen. Hey, I called on him that night, and Jesus came into my life. Amen. He done something that mom and daddy couldn't do, grandma and grandpa couldn't do. Hey, there's a lot of people, I believe this with all that's in me, is sitting in the house of God thinking because mom and dad's a Christian, that makes me a Christian. Hey, he told Nicodemus, he said, you must be born again. If you ain't born again, honey, mom and dad. Grandma and Grandpa, they can go to heaven, but you'll go to hell unless you take and are born again. Amen. It's that simple. It ain't what you used to be. Who are you now? Amen. Too many peoples are living back yonder. Boy, they used to be on fire for God. What's wrong now? Amen. Can I go a little farther with that? He said, love not the world, neither the things are in the world. If any man loves the world, the love of the Father's not in him. You know why we don't have the power we used to have? We're loving too much of the world. Hey, we need to get back loving God, honey. Why did he move last night? He was lifted up. He was lifted up. I'll tell you something tonight. You'll not make heaven on your goodness. You can be the honest fella in the world, best fella in the world. But if you don't have Jesus in your life, you're hell bound. Amen. It's that simple. But oh, here these Pharisees, they was looking down on Jesus. But that's who he came for. Listen, you hear people say, I found the Lord. You better read your Bible again. Jesus said, I come to seek and save that which was lost. That's the book. Amen. Hey, you remember the day that you got saved? You wasn't looking for him, but he was a sure looking for you. Amen. And he knowed exactly where he is at. Amen. Glory to God. I'm glad of that, ain't you? Well, praise his holy name. Hey, we went to the great physician, the physician that made us. Amen. One that knows more about us than we know about ourselves. Amen. So as we look tonight, do we have a need? Do we have a need tonight? See, as I tuck, I love Brother Gary. But I wasn't going to just see him. I went to him because I needed him.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Count him a dear friend.
Yeah.
But I'm going to tell you something. I know he'd help me if I get over fire.
Yeah.
And I got over fire, and guess what he done? He helped me. Amen. Hey, how about you? Jesus sent this for you tonight.
Yes, yes.
He wants to help you as he helped these publicans and sinners. He can help you tonight. Amen. So tonight as you look at your life, what do you really need? What do you need? Do you need the touch of the Master? Huh? Do you need that sweet, settled peace down deep inside of you? Amen. See, I can keep right on naming and naming. He's just exactly what you need. It doesn't matter what it is. You know, we think, well, this is a huge thing. Not to God, it ain't. Amen. You can take the most biggest problem that you ever had, and he can take care of that. You can take and have the smallest problem, and he'll take care of that. Amen. Boy, I'm so glad the Lord brought it to my attention. I'll share something with you. Listen to me. I'm glad when that old devil comes our way and we feel like that we're just about to go under. Boy, he comes on the scene. That Kevin shared with us, with him, night before last. God come to my rescue. He delivered me. Amen. Hey, when you can't go no farther, hey, he's got exactly. Wayne, he had exactly what I needed to take and keep a going. Amen. Hey, how many times have you took and got to a place in your life, Lord, I cannot do nothing else. And that's when his big loving arms just takes and cuddle you up and say, hey, it's all right. Amen. Glory to God. I'm glad of that. I'm glad I'm serving that type of God tonight. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Whatever your problem is tonight, whatever your need is tonight, honey, you need to take and come to the great physician. He'll take care of that problem. Listen at me. You want me to tell you something? It ain't people's drinking or drugs that causes them to go to hell. You know what causes them to go to hell? Unbelief. They will not believe. Except ye believe, you can't be saved. Amen. For by grace through faith are ye saved. And that not of yourselves, it is a gift of God. Not of works, lest any man should boast. I'm so glad it's all about Him. Amen. He's the one that can take and change your life. He's the one that can can one make a difference? Can we go back to that just a minute? He's the one that can take and make you that one to make a difference. Amen. And so as we look at our lives tonight, what is your need? What is the Lord dealing with your heart right now? I don't know nobody's heart but mine. But I know one thing. Somebody needs to get to the great physician. Amen. Needs to get to that one. Hey, you remember the little old woman that had the issue of blood? You remember that? That little old woman spent everything she had. Yet though she grew worse. But she said, listen at this. But if I could but just touch the hem of his garment, I know, not guess, not hope, but I know I'll be made whole. Amen. When you get to the point that you can believe that God is greater than any problem, any need, listen, if he can
If he spoke this thing into existence, what are you facing that he can't handle? He's the one that made you. Amen? So I'm sure that he's able to take care of whatever your need is. And he told them, down there in verse 13, but go ye and learn what this meaneth. Okay? I will have mercy and not sacrifice. For I am not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. Amen. So tonight, Jesus said, it's not my will that any perish, but that all come to repentance. Amen. Listen to me. There is not a person in here can be good enough to go to heaven.
That's right.
Nobody. I don't give a care who you are. I don't care how good a person you are. Hey, and I want to say it again. It ain't what you used to be. What are you right now? Huh? Are you walking fellowship with the Lord? Are you walking hand to hand with Him? Amen? I'm going to tell you something. A lot of people has took that used to walk close to God is following Him afar off. What did Peter do? He is ready to give his life for Jesus. But he denied Him, didn't he? What did he wind up doing? He is walking afar off. I preached a message one time on that, the danger of following the Lord afar off. I'm going to tell you something, it's dangerous. I'm going to tell you, listen to me tonight. You better walk close to God. Hey, without Him, you can't make it, and I can't neither. But I'll tell you something. If I stay with Him, I'll make it. More than anything, youngest, we've got to make it. Amen? And tonight, I don't know how you stand. But God does. God does. Hey, He came that you could go free. He laid down His life. He paid your sin debt and my sin debt in full. If you die and go to hell, you can blame yourself. But it's not His will that you die lost. Said, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son. Got two boys. I ain't never seen a person that loved either anybody worth every one of their lives. But God had one Son. That's heaven's best. He gave His Son that you and I could have life. Now I want to tell you something. That's love. That's love. No greater love than this than a man lay down his life for his friends. He said, you are my friends. If you do whatsoever that I command you. I'll go ahead with that. God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believe in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Glory. Amen. I praise and honor Him tonight that He paid my sin debt in full. So tonight, hey, if you need help tonight, He'll help you. The great physician chair. He wants you to know, I can take care of your problem tonight. Whatever it is. Oh, listen. I was thinking about, you know, when you repair something, you've got to take and do a lot of work on it, and it'll still be just an old person, an old vehicle. But you know, when He makes us a new creature, we ain't no rebuilt one. We're a brand new creature. Said, old things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. That is what He does to those that will trust and believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. He will make a brand new creature out of Him. That old man that used to do all those worldly things won't do that no more, Wayne. He's a brand new creature. So tonight, is the Lord speaking to your heart and said, you need to bring this to me tonight. I can take care of that. as I went down at Brother Gary's. I didn't waste time to get there. I wanted help. You may be to the point tonight that, hey, you're tired of living in fear. You're tired of taking and thinking, if I die, I know I'll go to hell. You don't have to live that way, youngins. You don't. You can have blessed, I love that song, blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Mike, ain't a lot of things that I can say that's really mine, but I can say He's mine tonight. I know that. Do you know that tonight? Amen. Do you know that tonight? Well, glory to God, do you know that tonight? If you don't know that, you can come and you can know that tonight. But it's up to you. You know, I take Him. Think of the Scripture. He said, I stand at the door and knock. Said, if any man, I believe that's woman, boy, or girl, hears my voice and opens the door, said, I will come in and sup with he and he with me. He'll never force His way in nobody's life. But He will gently wane, stand there and knock. And you know what? He's only obligated one time to knock upon your heart's door. But it's not His will that you die lost. That's why He keeps coming back and coming back and coming back and give you opportunity after opportunity to get saved. So tonight, you may be a sitting there and your heart feels like it's about to come out of you. I tell you what you need to do. You need to come to the great physician. Come to one who can help you. His name is Jesus. Come on. Come on. Come tonight. Come. He said, come unto me, all ye that are labored and are heavy laden. And He said, I'll give you rest. Hey, you can go tonight and lay down. And you don't have to worry whether daylight ever comes or not. I like that. Whether I live or die, I'm His. Amen. And having that blessed assurance of knowing that, knowing that all's well. Honey, I'd rather have that than have everything this world has of knowing there is a better day for the children of God. Amen. And so as we look, will you trust Him tonight? Somebody, as the Lord is speaking to your heart. Hey, now, hey, you can say anything you want to. Amen? But do you know tonight down here? May I share just a little something with you? Now I'm coming to close. Listen to me. My daddy took and got Alzheimer's. My Aunt June's brother had Alzheimer's. He forgot every one of us, but he never did forget the Lord. You know why? He had him down here. He didn't have him up here. He had him down here. Daddy would take and lay there. And I would take and we had to watch him 24/7. I would be a sitting there trying to study for the message. Daddy would take and I'd see Daddy's pain. You could see an expression on his face. He'd get worse and worse and worse. Daddy'd start praying. He'd lift his hands up like that and say, Jesus, I can almost touch you. He'd get a thanking Him for saving him. He'd get a thanking Him for everything that He'd done for him. And I'd see the Lord just take and cuddle him. Just let him drop off to sleep. I'll tell you something. Hey, He's sufficient for whatever that you stand in need of tonight. Hey, did He not tell us that I'll never leave you nor forsake you, but go with you all the way, even to the end of the world? He stayed with Daddy Mike till He took him out of here, amen. Daddy didn't know me, but He sure knew the one that could help him. Whoa, glory to God, I know something, honey. He can help you tonight. He can do for you like nobody else can do. Amen. Glory to God. Thank Him for His power tonight. Listen, that day is going to come for you and for me. And there ain't a doctor, no matter how good he may be, when it comes crossing time, honey, they ain't nothing that'll save you. I get a thinking back about the Word. He said He breathed into a man's nostrils the breath of life, and he became a living soul. Honey, when he pulls that breath, you're gone. They can put you on any machine they want to, and you're still gone. Amen. So tonight, the Bible said today's the day of salvation. Now accepted time. Why? Why, you're in your right mind and God is dealing with you. You know, people think, well, I'll get saved now, I won't to. No, you won't neither. Bible said, except the Spirit draw you, you can't even be saved. Amen? He's got to draw you. But now, honey, hey, if He's a drawing you tonight, that's your night. I remember my night in 65. It was my night. Hey, I don't know if anybody else got saved that night but me. See, that is my night. It doesn't matter how many get saved. See, it's a personal thing. It ain't a crowd thing. It's a personal thing. A personal salvation. Amen? But whosoever can take and be in that crowd, amen, they can come. But it's up to you. But it's up to you. He'll not force His way. Oh, listen, if He's knocking upon your heart right now, listen at me. You know how close you are to eternity? One heartbeat. That's how close you are. That heart quits beating, and wherever you made preparations for that inward man, that's where he's going. That's where he's going. You're going to a place of rest. You know, people say, boy, I've been through hell. No, you ain't. You don't even know what even half of that is. Amen. You listen to me real closely. Tonight, if Jesus came to your house, what would mean more to you than anything else? You want me to tell you what that'd be? Of knowing that all's well between you and Him. Amen. Hey, you could have billions of dollars. Won't mean a thing to you. All that's going to matter is knowing all is well between you and the Lord, that He's your Lord and Savior. So tonight, the Lord is speaking to your heart. This is your night. I cherish that night in 65. I have to go back to that. When the old devil gets trying to tell me it ain't never been saved, I can take him back to the spot. Wayne, I can say right here is where I total surrendered to the Lord. Tonight, I believe with everything that's in me, He's calling somebody right now. He's wanting to help you. He's wanting to do something for you that nobody else can do. He can make a new creature out of you tonight. You can say this or that. I can't take and live right, or I can't do this, or I can't give up that. Honey, I want to tell you something. The only thing you need to give up is just give up to the Lord and say, Jesus! Him, have mercy upon me. Save me from that awful place called hell. You hear people say, I'm going to have a ball in hell. Did you ever read the Word? He said there's weeping, wailing, and gnashing of teeth. What kind of party would that be? I'm talking about forever. You know, we think of something burning up, Wayne, it just, it's destroyed, it's gone. I want to tell you something. Those that goes to hell is going to last just as long as those that goes to heaven. These up here is going to take and have a rest, an eternal rest. Alan, that they won't be no more of these things that come our way. But that other place is torment, weeping, wailing, and gnashing of teeth forever. Now, it's your choice. He could have made us live right if He'd have wanted to, but He didn't. He gave us a choice. Our choice. Do you want to live in pleasure, or do you want to live in torment? And when I say pleasure, oh, what a nonner hit's going to be. to go to a place that I'll never have to say, Satan, get behind me again. Right. Honey, that ought to excite us enough to shout, amen? Amen. Amen. I'm going to that place. Are you going to that place? Yes. I've made preparations. Yeah. Bless his name. Tickets done been paid in full.
Yes. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Yeah. But it's Jesus speaking to your heart tonight and saying, come. You're not ready to go. You need to come to the great physician and let him do a work in your life as only he can. Every head be bowed. Come, sister. I want you to play just as I am, if you would, please. Jesus wants you just as you are. He's saying, come unto me. And I'm going to give you rest. Amen. Is there another? Come on. The Lord is speaking to your heart right now. Amen. Come on. Whatever your need is, you need to come right now. Come. Come on. Come. He's wanting to do a work in your life. Well, glory to God. But it's your choice. You want to let Him? I trusted Brother Gary as I went for help that day. Will you trust Jesus tonight for the help for you tonight? Amen. Come on. Come on. The Lord is speaking to your heart. Will you trust Him? Is that problem or that need that you have big? Then you can handle. Bring it to Jesus. Will you do that tonight? Will you do that tonight? How about, are you ready to meet God tonight? If He calls you right now, are you for sure that all's well between you and the Lord? Is there another need to come? Come on. Is there another? Come on, the Lord's speaking. He's drawing. He's drawing. Will you come? I believe there's others that the Lord is speaking to. He's wanting to help you. You look around and you see what the Lord done last night. And you feel like that you're sitting there thinking, Lord, I'd like to have what they've got, what they're shouting about. You can. You can. If you'll come and let Him do a work in your life. Come on. I believe there's others God's speaking to. Will you come tonight? Will you say, Lord, it's me. I need you to do a work in my life as only you can. How about it? Who else needs to come? I appreciate these honest hearts, but I feel like there's others God's speaking to tonight, saying, come, come. I want to save you tonight. I want to give you that peace that you don't have to take and worry about dying. You can have that peace of having that blessed assurance of knowing all's well between me and God. Come on, who else needs to come tonight? As God is speaking to your heart, please come. There's others God's speaking to, please. I want to tell you something. If He's dealing with you, it's your night. I'd come right now. Come on. Doesn't matter what somebody else thinks about you. They may think you're the finest person in the world. You better take and be concerned about the one that knows about you. Knows all about you. Come on. Is there another need to slip out and say, it's me, Lord. I need your help. Just as you are. That's the way He wants you. Just as you are right now. Come on. The Lord's speaking to your heart. Come on. Come on, who else needs to come? Will you come tonight? Please come. Please come. Don't let this opportunity pass you by. You don't know if you'll live to see tomorrow. I don't know that. But I'll tell you one thing. You better take and be ready to meet God. You say, preacher, I'll take and do that right before I leave. Honey, you may leave in a split second. Matter of fact, you might leave while you're sleeping. Then what would happen? How about it? The Lord is speaking to your heart right now. Come on. Come on. You know where you stand. Come on. How about it tonight? As God is taking, speaking to your heart, I feel like He's reaching out, saying, come. Come. Please come tonight as Jesus is speaking to you. Please come. Oh, I want you to take. He's wanting to come into your heart and your life. He wants to make you a brand new creature. Put that peace and that joy, that happiness down deep inside of you, honey, that you can lift up holy hands and send glory, be the Lamb of God. How about it? Come on. Is there another need to come? God's speaking. Come on, He's speaking. He's dealing with hearts tonight. Come on. Please come. If you need something from the Lord, you're going to have to take and ask Him for it. Bible said you receive not because you ask not. If you'll ask, you can receive. It's your choice. Your choice. Come on. Who else needs to come? I appreciate all these has come tonight. How about it? Will you come tonight as Jesus speaks to your heart? I have not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. He's still will save that old sinner if he'll take and call upon Him. Is there another need to come tonight? Will you come? I appreciate these hearts that's come tonight. Heavenly Father, these precious hearts that's come tonight, Lord, I pray that You'll just give them the desires of their heart tonight. You said You would, and I know You will. Lord, but I believe there's others tonight that You're calling tonight that needs to surrender to You tonight. Please, Lord, help them to don't leave tonight without knowing that they know that they know that they're saved. Help them tonight, Lord, to surrender to You tonight because, Lord, we don't know what another day holds for us. But I am so glad that we can know who holds tomorrow. Praise Your holy name. Bless now and help these that's come. Help them to leave it all in Your hands, totally surrendered to You. In Jesus' lovely name, amen and amen. Amen. Amen.